Let me pay a prayer to Lord. Puthavale, Punam Padinan Gneim Puthavanam Kathavale, Pin Karandavale, Karek Kandanakamuthavale, Endrumuva Mundet Kalevale, Matavale Unyandri, Matur Devam Mandipale. Okay, this song says, the Lord has created this universe, the different planetary system, and facilitated us to live here, and everything granted, the providence is there. You don't need to create anything to import from anywhere. It's basically provided, but we have been given with this engine, one of the best engine ever created. That's a human body. So you know engineer means, actually the root word may be engine. So in Tamil also, Pori Lala. So you are also going to create engines, or maintain engines, and design, innovate. Then guess best out of that machine. So now things has gone to artificial intelligence. Even Moratorium University, a new degree program start. Bachelor of Artificial Intelligence. This year they commence. Yesterday I was with the Vice Chancellors about the programs. The Moratorium introduced a program called Bachelor of Engineering in Artificial Intelligence. So that means the humans, we are now making endeavor to create another human. Not by reproduction, by engineering. So genetic engineering coming, quantum engineering coming. So the quantum theories, now engineering merging with so many other, I am from the science faculty, I am a mathematician. So I know. So it's no more, it's a traditional conservative things anymore. Because, you know, this 21st century, the knowledge expansion is to the peak, is expanding in exponentially great way because of the tools the scientist has. Now even the drone flying in the Mars, so that level things have been moving. So let us go to the anything if you want to do, but it has to come from the first step. You can't just fly without having the basic thing done. So that is the first degree all about. So now you are commencing your tertiary program. So you were in the secondary school, now you are in the university. So university is the best tertiary place in this country. So university is basically a knowledge center. So Lord Krishna says, little advancement of knowledge may save us from the greatest fear of life. So for example, COVID-19 threatened us for the last year, March onwards. But now we are in the endeavor of actually establishing the vaccine. So that remove the threats. Actually our anxiety settled down. So we free from anxiety. At least we know the doctors are working hard. So in that sense, the knowledge, little advance of knowledge may save us from the greatest fear of life. So here, the universe is a knowledge center. As we are a human being, so we have a physical existence. So we came with this body. So the body has everything. The structure is there, so structural engineering there, the fleet mechanics there, the air conditioning system working, 98.4 centigrade is maintained, Fahrenheit is maintained, irrespective of what are the external condition may be. So actually our body itself is a air conditioning system. Since the birth till death, it maintains. The heart is pumping. Since the birth till the death is pumping. The earth is rotating around the sun. Okay? What is the principle there? As a mathematician, I know a central force system. The sun stays in the focus and we are in an elliptical path. So whoever put that earth initially in a kind of angular momentum, that angular momentum kept preserved. even the engineering faculty, there is a department called engineering mathematics. Here it's called multidisciplinary system. So the earth is rotating, it's a heavy mass, but no noise, no one service it, no solar panels, nothing. Where there are plants are there. The engineers create plants, the electrical plants, you know, electric generating plants. So similarly, fossil fuel generator plants, atomic nuclear generator plants, all are there. The sun is there. This is work with the nuclear reactor. This is a fission reactor. So it's a fusion reactor. So it's everything going together and creating the energy. We are trying to figure it out. We understand the mechanism of sun. The hydrogen merge and the helium comes and the energy comes. But we're trying to create that reactor in the earth, but we're unable to do it. Our one is the fission one. So nuclear split and energy come, the uranium. So there's a long way to go, this journey. So now we are old people, we are generation. So we become a maintainer of education. So public fund is done. So we are now going to give this responsibility to you. Now if you look at you, I congratulate you because you are one of the elite group. I know your SAT score is 1.9, 1.8 and so on, around 2. That means you are in the, as a mathematician I know, the first 2% of the cream of the people. So today I'm happy, I'm with the cream of the cream of the cream of the GCA level. When you are starting with school maybe 20 years ago, 19 years ago, there are 400,000 people in the cohort would have started the education. Now only the elite 1,200 people or 1,500 people come into the math stream and they've come up with the engineers. So you have a very sophisticated life ahead, you know, to you, looking forward to. But for that, you have to work hard. You can't rest in the university. You will understand when you are in the A level, you have been fed. You know, system was very spoon-feeding system in Sri Lanka. Everyone preparing very hard to come out of the bottleneck that called A-level competitive setup because it's allied studies. So you succeeded coming out of the this bottleneck. For that you work very hard, but the preparation was not good. No independent thinking, no kind of own perseverance, or no self-learning. You know, you have been practicing 10 years past papers and you had a skill, the spark, and you used it and come in. The university, very intensive program. You know, the 4 years going to be very, 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 very intensive. It's a knowledge-based, skill-based, attitude-based, mindset-based. So it's called KSAM. You know, knowledge, skill, attitude, mindset. The courses are designed like that. So when you come out of this system, you will be a complete personality. Not only we teach engineering, we teach other things. Management, entrepreneurial things, aesthetic things. There are so many, apart from the core courses, there are so many electrical courses. And the curriculum chairman of the university. So I know this curriculum design and all this. So where we have been putting a lot of things. Again, you have barriers, the language barriers some of you have. So this is a place for you to, you know, when you are, now you are like, you are thrown at the deep side of the pond. If you don't, you know, move your arms and leg in a synchronized manner, you are going to drown into the pond. Because now you don't know, you think you are simply here. So now you are in the deep side of the pond. Unless you work hard, you know, you put your energy, you have this talent, but easy to be out of focus. So I don't want to preach on this. I know, even yesterday I had a Senate, I had so many appeals from engineering, and they were ignorance. They were not registering courses, not registering for exams, having a lot of trouble and missing and failing. And you know, you don't know that. They all look normal. But here they are not putting their work in. So, ladies and gentlemen, the countries depend on you. So, you are the future designers. You are the future builders. You are the future innovators. You are the future managers. You are the future planners. So, you are the future, you know, entrepreneurs. You are the future, you know, business management. You know, ladies and gentlemen, even I'm an engineer. I was involved in the designing of this faculty also at some stage, as Dean said. Then I was working with the faculty of technology. Then there was a big engineer working with me, Professor Piersri. He was a vice chancellor and a moratorium professor. They told me, out of the engineers from the moratorium, you know, moratorium is one of the elite places now. 50 years ago, it was a technical college. So the people, they have worked hard. I think our engineers also, staff also dedicated. Within 4 or 5 years, they made this place magnificent. Look at the buildings. Look at things. Although the harsh weather, but the Jaffna man known for hard working. You know, we don't have river, we don't have ponds. One of the best educated people in this country come from this part of the world. Best engineers, best doctors. We were talking about Turraja. Even go to Peridania. The jet engine is there. Professor Mahalingam is from our place. He was the first mechanical engineer, brought a lot of glory to things. Even most of the engineers are very, very much obliged to our Jaffna engineers. So what I'm saying is we have a great education tradition. So we are not the kind of people make up things. We don't believe in makeup. We believe in genuine delivery, hard working. Here even people fight each other too much in the engineering faculty just to maintain the quality, not for anything else. Not for getting some fringe benefits. So really they work hard. So they expect you work hard. Otherwise, you know, when you have aspiration and if you don't work for that aspiration, then you end up with a misery. So I really warn you that this is the time for you to dig further and work hard. Say, we have 2,000, more than 2,000 year history in this country. So the King Parakram Pagu developed a tank on those days in Polonnaruwa. Now we are even difficult to maintain that tank. Put a select gate and maintaining the gateways, we are asking for World Bank donation. But these people built by themselves 2,000 years ago. The country like Australia, only 200 years old. Only criminals went there. 1796, Captain Cook arrived there. Now the country is best for everything, more or less. Only the size of Sri Lanka. Harsh weather. The weather is even 10 degrees higher than Sri Lanka. All snakes are there. Venom snakes are there. But these Australians work hard. You know how they play cricket, you know. The Australian way is hard way. You know, that's the way they are. So similarly, ladies and gentlemen, this is your time to deliver. We'll support you as a, you know, your dean said. Your team is a very good team. Even recently, we got a professor from your faculty. The people in the selection board very happy about his credentials. So Professor Sasivaran is a civil head also, no? So he's a recent professor. There are a pile of professors going to come. So that's the best recognition. The IES also recognition. And here the dean said, as a curriculum commissioner, curriculum committee chairman, I say, not only we are looking for IESL accreditation, Institute of Engineers Sri Lanka, we are looking for Washington Accord also. So that means you will be global passport you will have, not a Sri Lankan passport. And that's what we change our curriculum into 8 semester into 3 semester, and our credit system is overloaded. When you come to other faculties, my faculty and Rajyomi's faculty, the student council faculty, we only give 120 hours, 120 credits training, 120 into 15 hours of contact hours we give for our graduates, the volume of learning. Here, the volume of learning for engineers is 150, 155, because we want to meet the Washington Accord. Washington Accord accreditation means you will have an international passport. For example, I had my degrees. When I arrived in Australia, they gave me an Australian passport because you are allied. You stay here, they said. Okay, wherever you go, carry this passport. You know, that's a skill kind of thing you get. So that's what we are aiming for. So ladies and gentlemen, don't worry about whether you didn't go to Peridania or Moratuwa. You are in a place, this place is well known for, not like Moratuwa. Moratuwa is famous for furniture, right? Moratuwa Mulya and all this. But this Jaffna is famous for education. Top schools generated 200 years ago. Top medical schools generated. Top maths, mathematics culture is here. And the top people in the Peridania who have inaugurated everything come from this part of the world. So I think you are in the right place, in the right time. All the things are set up. I think you are blessed. I congratulate you. I wish you all the best in the life. And, you know, as a human being, we had to celebrate our life. I think life is a celebration. So every day should be a celebration. So anything happened to you that is not tolerable, please report to the system and we'll take care of it. And thank you very much for accepting our place as your choice. And I wish you all the best. And may I pray the Lord also bless you, prosperous and happy life in your future. Thank you very much.